Hello children, welcome to church today. How are you doing? Trust I had a very good week. I had a good week too. My name is Yemisi Alfonso. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. Thank you for the gift of life. Lord, we are grateful for our family members. We are grateful for our mommies and our daddies. We are thankful for our uncles and our aunties, for our siblings. Thank you for keeping us. We say we are grateful unto you in Jesus' name. Thank you for being our help. Thank you for always helping us when we need our help. We are grateful to you. Lord, as we study at your feet today, help us to be doers of your word in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray that you will give us an understanding of your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. It's going to be a wonderful time in God's presence this morning, right? So ensure you get your Bibles, you get your books and your Bibles. Ensure you listen attentively, pay good attention, and then learn your memory verse. And of course, remember to live what you have learned. We are God's general, and as such, we should behave like one. Have a great time in God's presence. See you.
Just a reminder, the Upton Science Fair is in 3 weeks. That's not a lot of time, so you better be working hard.
I need to get going on building that robot for the science fair. I know, I could get Theo to help me. He's so good with computers and tech stuff. Hey, Theo, wait up! I'm trying to build a robot for science fair. Could you help me?
Okay, but you have to be committed to build a robot.
Well, I've done a few things, but I haven't had time to really finish anything, and I don't understand programming.
If we commit to this project, we will work every day after school until it is finished. I can help you with the programming too. This is a huge commitment. Are you ready for it?
You bet! We got it built, Theo. Now all we need is the coding to make it work.
Okay, now let's get started coding.
This is so hard, I feel like my brain's gonna explode.
Don't give up, Ryan. You're really getting the hang of this, and we're almost finished.
Come in!
Hey, Ryan. A bunch of us are meeting at the park. Do you wanna come?
No thanks, Gerald. Me and Theo are really committed to this robot for science fair. And if we stop now, it won't finish itself.
And now, the top winners of our Upton Science Fair. Ryan and Theo with an amazing project where they built a working robot.
Everyone, my name is Rolo Akitontubi, and I'm here to take the confession. Please say after me. In the name of Jesus, I declare that I am more conscious day by day of the Spirit of God. I live in the Spirit. I walk in the Spirit. I speak by the Spirit. And I am full of the Spirit. The Holy Spirit is my teacher. He teaches me all I need to know. And he brings all things to my remembrance. My steps are ordered by God's word, and my mind is renewed daily by the word of God. The love of God is shed abroad in my heart by the Holy Ghost. I am a loved being. Therefore, I love all people around me because my Father is my shepherd. I declare that I do not want. I have everything that I need. The Lord supplies all my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I will speak the word of God with boldness to my friends and people around me. The Holy Spirit will speak through me to reach out to the lost. They will listen to me and they will be saved. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I am sensitive to the leading of the Holy Spirit. I make the right decisions by the Spirit. I rejoice in Jesus. I have no fear, because the greater one lives bigger me. I am a winner. Hallelujah.
Hello, children. How are you? And happy Sunday. I hope you're enjoying yourself as we started the service today. I will be talking about something very important to you as children, and it is what I title peer pressure. But before we start, let us pray. Our Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for your word this morning. Thank you because you will teach us, you will understand, and our lives will be the better for it. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Amen. Okay. So this morning, we'll be talking about what I said earlier as peer pressure. Peer pressure. Now, what is peer pressure? Peer pressure is when you let your friends make you do something or behave in a way that you would not ordinarily behave in. I'll say it again. Peer pressure is when you let your friends make you do something or behave in a way that you would naturally not behave in. Or we can say peer pressure is when you do or say things because you want to be like your friend. How many of us do those things? Because your friends are wearing short socks and all of them are wearing short socks, you tell mommy you also want to wear short socks to school. Or maybe your friends like to bring spaghetti to school. you also want to bring spaghetti to school. Praise the Lord. Because that is what your friends are doing. Now, there are two types of peer pressure. What did I say? There are two types of peer pressure. It's either it is a good peer pressure or bad peer pressure. I'll say that again. It's either it's a good peer pressure or bad peer pressure. Now, peer pressure does not always have to be bad. It doesn't have to be bad. We can also have good peer pressure. Hallelujah. Now, what are the examples of good peer pressure? Let's take a few examples. For example, if you don't like reading your books, when you come back from school, you just dump all your books somewhere, remove your clothes, eat your food, and you are playing till the end of the day. You don't read your books. But you now have friends who love to read. And they tell you, look, if you want to be our friend, you must read your book, because we don't like people who don't pass the exams very, very well. And because your friends are always reading and they're always doing well in their exams, you also start to read at home. When you come back from school, you no longer play. You will now carry your book and you are reading it, because you want to be like your friend who is always first position or having A's in his results. That is a good peer pressure. Another example of good peer pressure is when you and your friends decide to help your parents at home. For example, the example I used before, when you come back from school and you just drop everything, you will not keep your books, you will not keep your bags, you will not take care of yourself, you just drop everything everywhere, and then you go to school and your friends are saying, me, I wash plates. So when I come back from school, I wash the plates. My mommy will not allow me to play if I don't wash the plates. Or another friend of yours says, I'm the one that cleans my own room. Another one says, I must sweep the floor. My mother has given me a portion of the house that I must clean before I go to school. And they now ask you, so what about you? What do you do at home? And you tell them, I don't do anything. I just get home and I throw my bags and my books everywhere. And I don't wash, I don't clean, and they're like, So you mean you don't do anything in the house? That's no good. You should tell your mommy that you want to help her. Tell her to give you something to do. And when you start doing that, that is what we call a good peer pressure. Now, let's go to some examples of bad peer pressure. I hope you are still following me. Bad peer pressure. When you allow your friends who steal or take things that do not belong to them, push you into doing that same thing. You start stealing your friend's pencil. You start taking other people's things home because your friends do it. And they will tell you, nobody can catch me. I took biro. I took my friend's pencil. When I didn't have a razor, I collected his own and I took it home. And you two start doing that. You start stealing other people's things. That is what we call a bad peer pressure. Hallelujah. Or maybe your friends, they like to bully people. They like to bully other, students in school. They'll be making fun of them, calling them different kinds of names. Look at his head. Look at his mouth. He can't even talk very well. He can't even play. Look at his leg. He cannot walk well. Look at him. And you now too, you now join them. You didn't used to do that before. But because you want to be like your friends, you want them to think that you are part of them. You too start to abuse people, abuse your teachers, abuse your friends, your schoolmates. You are disobedient. You are always in the wrong place. When they ring the bell, you know, for lunch break to be over, you'll be running all over the place. That is an example of a bad peer pressure. You are allowing them to make you to do things that are not right. And that is not good for you as a child of God. Praise the Lord. God wants you to be a good child and to avoid all those friends that will be teaching you bad things. All those friends that will be teaching you things that are not good. It is not advisable for you to follow those kind of friends because they will lead you into trouble. They will land you in big trouble. Praise the Lord. Now, if you have those kind of friends, or you have some of those people as friends, how do you handle when they want to teach you something bad? Let me show you a secret in the Bible. In Proverbs chapter 1, verse 10, it says, "Dear friend, if bad companies tempt you, don't go along with them." In other words, when your friends are teaching you to do bad things, when they want to entice you to do bad things, say no. What did I say? Say no to them. Refuse to allow them to push you to do things that are bad. Praise the Lord. Another way to avoid negative peer pressure is choose your friends wisely. Don't work with bad friends. Evil communication will corrupt good manners. Stay away from them. Work with the boys and girls that are good, that are obedient, and listen to their parents and their teachers. And as you do that, you will avoid negative peer pressure. God bless you in Jesus' name as you do that. Amen.
Hello, children. Hi there. Let's be reminded of the following. We are reminded to learn our memory verse. All our activities, learn your memory verse, memorize it, and say it. Hallelujah. It's now time for us to take our confession. Let's go. I am an overcomer. I'll keep God's word in my heart to observe and to practice in faith, in love, and in joy. I will live sensitive to the Spirit, thereby making my way prosperous this week and enjoy success as God's light to the glory of my Father. Amen. Have a great week, children. God bless you.